My name is Mariana Kersh, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Science and Engineering, and I'm a biomechanist. So by training, I'm a mechanical engineer, and we use mechanical engineering principles to solve musculoskeletal problems. The horn study is all over the media right now. Somebody published a cross-sectional study based on x-rays and split them up into ages, and what they found is at the base of the skull, the younger people have this extra bit of bone. And in cross-section, it looks like a horn. It looks like spiky at the skull. And so the media has picked up on this and said, you know, people are growing horns at the back of their heads. And then the authors of the paper in the discussion try to explain this finding by suggesting that it's a handheld device use. But doing this is not gonna cause bone adaptation within a single lifetime. You have to have really, we try and get adaptation by having people jump around, and we can't get adaptation. So small postural changes that are not even dynamic, so you're just kind of statically loading the tissue, is not gonna do anything. But anyway, I was scared to make that CNN comment, and then I was like, I know what I'm talking about.